In a joint operation, the Uganda People's Defense Forces and the Armed Forces of the Democratic Republic of Congo have successfully rescued 23 people from the clutches of the Allied Democratic Forces terrorists. The operation took place near River Malibong, north of Tokomeka in Ituri province. The rescued people, including 16 women and 7 men, were received at the UPDF tactical headquarters in Luna, Ituri province, after being extracted from the jungle by the Joint Mobile Forces. Among the rescued are 13 minors, including 3 infants under the age of 1, who are malnourished and are currently receiving emergency care from a joint medical team.
Abantu abiri mu basatu abo abasinga mulimu bakyala naye ate ekinnaku nti abaana 18 abaana 17 abantu 17 bali wansi wa myaka 18 ninga mulimu n'abatonnyo abenyezi abali wansi w'omwaka ogumu kyennaku nnyo ADF ekwata abakyala n'ekola n'abaana abato era abaana abataabo nebateekamu omutima ogw'ekitujju.
The mothers of the infants are also receiving basic medical treatment in the field, with arrangements underway to transfer them to a facility for more comprehensive care. Operation Shuja, now in its 31st month, aims to defeat the ADF, a terrorist organization affiliated with Islamic State. Officials from the Ministry of Health held a national induction for medical interns for the year 2024-2025. Over 2,500 medical interns will be posted at respective medical centers across the country.
This meeting is intended to transform medical doctors, nurses, midwives, and pharmacists who have been going through 5 or 4 years of training. So they are theoretically competent, examined by their various institutions, they have passed. But in this country, before you are given the authority to treat people, you must go through intense training of internship.
The interns expressed satisfaction with the facilitation of 1 million shillings which the ministry is offering, as opposed to 2.5 million shillings which was promised by the president.
Some 2 years back, the president of Uganda issued a directive that all interns should be paid half of a substantive cadre earns. So we want to know whether the ministry is going to implement that directive.
However, officials from the Ministry of Health said that due to the increased number of interns, the facilitation was revised from 2.5 million shillings per intern to 1 million shillings to fit within the available resource envelope. The government allocated about 35 billion shillings for the internship program.
The president, it is true, directed that we pay 2.5 per intern sometime back when the numbers, you know, were manageable. But because we operate a budget that has not grown, we discussed and agreed that for purposes of equity, given that the numbers had grown, we accommodate many numbers of interns and reduce, you know, the facilitation to 1 million.
The interns have, however, been advised to desist from protests as a way of solving grievances. The Chief Commissioner of the Uganda Scouts Association of Uganda, Alice Nyiramahoro, has appreciated their patron, President Yoweri Museveni, for steering the association over the years.
Uganda Scouts Association appreciates their patron, the President of the Republic of Uganda, His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni Tebuhaburwa, for immense and unwavering support.
Nyiramahoro also revealed that the preparations for their annual inter-patrol camping competitions are set for August 23rd to 28th at Kazi National Scouts Training and Camping Ground under the theme Scouting for a Better World.
The 2024 National Education Camp, which is going to take place on 23rd of August 2024. The camp scheduled to take place at the National Camping, at the Scouts National Camping and Training Ground in Kaz, Busabala.
This year's theme emphasizes the role scouting plays in shaping a better future. Nyiramahoro invited the general public to participate in this year's camp, saying that patriotism is part of the training.